teachers, lack of funding, and the start of the school year right around the corner. Tonight, parents, students, and teachers spoke out about their concerns with the Grand Ledge School District. It's our top story tonight at 11. Thanks for joining us. Teachers, students, school officials, and even lawmakers in Grand Ledge spent more than 2 hours hashing out a number of issues tonight. Lots of people are concerned about losing teachers. Since last year, 19 teachers in the Grand Ledge schools have left the district, a majority of them retiring. Our Alexander Illich was at tonight's meeting and shows us what happened inside. For more than 2 hours tonight, many teachers, parents, and students of Grand Ledge schools shared their tears and frustration with Senator Rick Jones and State Representative Tom Barrett, desperate to make a change in a district they say is slowly getting worse.
We're operating on about $6.5 million less today than we did in 2010-11.
Grand Ledge School Superintendent Dr. Brian Metcalf says part of that is because of a decrease in per-student funding and an increase in retirement benefits.
Right now we're paying about $9.1 million a year to the retirement system. 5 years ago we were paying somewhere around $4.8 million.
The Grand Ledge School District has more than 10 different schools, 5,100 students, taught by a total of about 280 teachers. But the loss of funds in the district over the years has caused some challenges.
We've made the decision again at the bargaining table to pay more, but to have people work harder, work on planning time, and that's very, very challenging for some of the teachers.
Some teachers say they haven't gotten pay increases in 10 years, and that's led some to resign. Many teachers tonight raised concerns about breach of contract, no planning time, and uncertainty surrounding the school calendar. It's a series of hurdles that forced Jessica Fuentes to resign after working in the district for 7 years.
The decision to leave was beyond difficult, but as I had family, I realized there was no way that I could balance my work and my family life. The stress that it causes is just, it's not worth the tiny stipend that the district offers.
I lost my journalism teacher. She was one of my favorite teachers. I don't think it's fair to us to start the school year with substitutes.
Both Senator Jones and I have been very vocally in support of maintaining proper funding for public education and keeping state dollars that are supposed to go into our K-12 schools going there instead of other parts of the state budget.
In Grand Ledge, Alexandra Illich, 6 News.
Thank you, Ellie. Now the Grand Ledge